Hey guys, today we have this 2007 Honda Civic, and the problem with these is the AC will not turn off. So we're gonna see the problem, diagnose it, confirm that it's the actual problem, and repair it. All right, let's get started. Okay, so the problem with this car is the customer said the AC, the air conditioning, would not turn off, which, you know, I asked for information what symptoms that he has, but right now we're gonna confirm it. It says that even you turn off the blower motor or the AC button, it's AC is still running. So let's just confirm that, if that's really the problem. First, you have to make sure if the AC is working, that, I'll show you, that's the AC right there. Compressor that should be always moving. Might be clutch, maybe that may be the AC clutch might be stuck, you know, but let's check it and verify the problem. Let's go start the car. Okay. Okay, the car starts and I can hear the fan, and it is cold. That's on. Turn it off, and I can see it's still cold. Okay. Make sure it's running. Let's turn off, and this is off. So the whole system should be off. Let's go check it out. So what I'm gonna do, the AC compressor clutch must be stuck on, but have to check if that's the problem or not. So we're gonna check the relay, if it's the relay. Sometimes if the relay is bad, it's always on. So we have to find where's the relay here. You see, we turn off the car. Okay. So a couple things. AC compressor clutch is always engaging, and that could cause either that's locked, or it could cause by the bad relay. If the relays always have power, it's always closed, it will gonna keep on sending power there. So let's go find the clutch, which is right there. That one says MG clutch 7.5 amps. Oh no, it's not it. That's the fuse. We know the fuse has power, so that means the fuse are okay. I would say that's the one in the bottom right here, which is this one. So what I'm going to do is remove that and that's the AC as well. So I'm going to gonna remove this one. See if I can remove it. Remove this first. So this is the AC clutch. And nope, I think that's for the AC clutch. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to remove that for now and start the car. Starts the car. I think it's off. I don't hear anything. Okay. Okay, that's off. As you can see, it's not moving. So that's good. So that means that AC clutch compressor is not it's not locked up. And this might be stuck closed. So this relay might be stuck closed. So what I'm gonna do, I'll try. Let me show you if I put it on. While I'm putting it on, I'm gonna watch that to turn on. Sure. So check it. Watch that compressor closely. I'm gonna put the relay back on. See that? On, off, on, off. Okay. We know it's not the AC compressor. It might be the relay. I'll see what I can do with the relay. Let me turn it off real quick. I'm gonna borrow another relay on the other side. If that one, there's no way, from my theory, there's no way all these relay are bad. So what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna borrow the one right here on top. This is the one I got it from top. This is from an AC compressor. I'm gonna put the AC compressor there. That should be working. And then I'm gonna do the same process here. If it's not, is that still doing? Because everything's off right now. If this one's still turning it on by itself with off switch, I don't think the relay is bad. I think the relay are good. I'm gonna knock off the list. Okay, let's start the car again. Okay. Okay. Make sure everything is, see that? Turn it off, off. And we're gonna check this one. If this really turn on, turns on that compressor. Okay, go ahead and put it in. See that? It's turning on. Still turning it on. Okay. So that means, let me turn off the car. We're still getting power. It doesn't matter. Turn it off. So the AC compressor is good. It's not locked up. I'm gonna put this back in. I don't think it's the relay problem. So this is good. AC compressor is good. Relay for me, I think it's good. So what I'm gonna do, so that means we have power coming in here all the time. I think it's generating this power from this line, from relay to the switch. So I'm gonna check the switch. The switch, if it's always on, even though you see the light, Let me show you. Let's show it. The light still on. I mean, it turns off. Let me start the car. Okay. So you can see, AC is off. That's off. So if this button is still sending power, even though the light is off, there might be a connection that the actual power is still sending to the relay. So the light button, it's okay, the indicator light, but I don't think it's still off. I think they're still sending power. So what I'm gonna do is remove these, check these if it's the problem. We're gonna remove everything. Here, I'll show you how to do it and how to check it. All right. Okay, so we have to remove this part here, which is the climate control. In order to remove that, we have to remove a couple pieces here, like this side and this side. So first thing is remove this bottom panel by your foot. All you do is just pull that down. Okay, then I'll just set it aside. Next thing, you have to remove this part, the top of the steering wheel. You have one screw here, and that's just only one, and the whole thing will pop right out. So put it on the side. This will come out. You can either pull it from here. Alright, just be careful. We're not removing the whole thing, we just trying to get that. Sorry. Anyway, okay. Once that's out, okay. One that's out. Now we can remove this part here, which it has a couple more screws down the bottom. So right down here, let me show you under your little compartment here, there will be a, see if I can show you those covers. Spy it out. Should come out. Once that's out, there will be two 10 millimeter screw. I mean 8 millimeter, but it's also a Phillips. Let me see if we can stick it in there. Right there, see that? So what I'm gonna use is this Phillips screw. I don't know if you can see it right there. So once that's out, let me see. There's one there. Let me show you. So one there, so one up there, and one on the other side. So you can use a 8 millimeter socket or a Phillips screw. So let me remove that and I'll show you what's next. Okay, so I got it out. Those are the two. As you can see, there's Phillips. At the same time, it's a 8 millimeter socket. So I'm gonna leave it there. Then now I believe you can remove the whole piece. I can yank it from this side. There you go. And from the bottom. There you go. These are all just tabs and clips. Make sure you don't break them. See that? Those are the tabs, clips. Same thing at the bottom side. So now that's out, I want to check. Let me see. I don't have to remove the whole piece. I'm just going to access it from the bottom. So let me see. What's that? Okay. Okay, so now we'll see what I can. I have to remove that. I'll show you. So this one can be able to remove. I will not remove the whole thing. I could, but I don't have to, because all I need is, let's see if I can relocate this thing. There you go, that's fine. Okay, all I need is this controls here, which I can see it back here, no problem. As you can see, that is the connection. I guess I can remove the whole piece. Let me see. Make it easier. That's the connector we need. And the radio. Okay, I'm not. I can, but I don't have to. So this is the connector right here that controls this. So when I unplug this and there's still power turning on my AC, that means there's like splice or a ground that at least a power from after this control from that wire to the relay. There's something powering aside from this, because this is what's powering it. But if that turns off, this is bad. The module is bad. So I'm gonna see if that will turn off. So right now, the car should be off. I mean, the AC should be off if I start the car. Let's start the car. Okay, guys, so I'm gonna start the car. I don't hear anything. So that is unplugged. So as you can see, there's no power. Let's see if that's turned off. Oh yeah, compressor is off. And let's see if I plug it in again, if it'll turn on. That I'm gonna plug it in again. Let's see, and that should turn it on, of course. Did you hear that? I know that's turned on. And this one is still off, see? Let me turn it off. That's off. Oh man, the wipers keep spraying some water in it. I have to fix this first. Sorry about that. Okay. Okay, let's do it again. Start it. Okay, that's off. And check it. That is off. Turn it on. Okay. See that? It's intermittent. Now it won't turn off. Blower. It's on. Let's turn it off. So sometimes it works, sometimes it's off. So now it's on, even though it's off. The switch is off. So what I'm gonna do is, let me check, disconnect that little light. Let me disconnect this. Let's disconnect that one. See, it's the switch. I can feel it. Let me disconnect that one. There you go. So now it's off. I disconnected it. And it turned it off. Let me get my flashlight one more time. Yeah, it's off. So what I'm going to do is replace that climate control. I'm going to replace that. I'm going to replace that. Lucky me, we have a parts car. Let's check it out. All right. As you can see, we're going to check. I do have another parts car for that. So I'm going to remove that climate control for the same car. Look at these. Look at these. There you go. I have another Civic here. This is year 2008, I believe. And I believe it's working properly. I already removed the climate control. I'm not going to show you how to remove it because I already showed you how to. And let's just check it out. That. This one has a screen on it, and I will remove that climate control, and I'll show you how to remove the one in the car and install the new one. Okay, so this car is still running. I already removed, as you can see, this is the other climate control we have from the other car. That's the bad one still there. Before I remove that, let me confirm it if it works. I'm gonna plug this in. Right now, the AC is off. I'm going to plug this in and verify if it fixed the problem. Okay. It didn't turn on. It's off right now. I have to remove this one. I can have to borrow it. Borrow the switch. There you go. It's out. We can borrow that switch from here. There you go. Make sure it's plugged in properly. There you go. I can hear it turn on and off. Hear that? Off. Let's do it again. So right now, that is off. Let me turn it on. AC on. Let's put it. So let's check it. If the compressor is on. Oh yeah, that is on. It's running. Then let's press it, turn it off. There's two ways to turn it off. Press the AC off. Okay, that's off. Let's check it again. Oh yeah, that is off. to that. Then the second way to check it if it's off is to, let's turn it on, then turn off the blower motor. That should turn off too. Oh yeah, that's off. That's it. I believe that fixed the problem. By switching with climate control. So what we're gonna do is to remove the old one and replace it with this new one. Now let's turn off the car. There you go. Okay. Now we confirmed that it was a bad climate control. We're gonna install this to this car. First, we have to remove these them from this panel here. So this has four screws. So you can see there's 1, 2, 3, 4. It's sitting behind it. So before you remove that, I already removed this piece here, which is that one, and I need to replace that one over there, which is this one. What I normally do is put it all the way to the left, so that's the position I'm gonna put it back in the to the new climate control and pry it. There you go, that's it. Pry it. And four screws. Let's remove it. Let me show you where is it at. Okay, you go from the back side. You can, you don't have to remove the whole piece. I think it's easier if you do, but I will not do it. I'm just gonna move it up like that. As you can see here, let's see, it's 1, 2. And right there, this one is 3, and on top is the fourth one. So remove those four and it will come out. And show you how it's done. All right, so now all the screws are out. We're gonna remove that. I guess they have one more. Let's see. The bottom one. Let's see. The last screw is right there. See that? That's the last one. Now that's totally out. Pull that out. Make sure it won't get switched with the old and new one. So that's the old one, and this is the new one. So what we're gonna do, just put it back, reverse, put the screws back in, and reinstall them. Make sure this is out. It's not gonna go in. Okay, let's do it. Okay, so now it's back. That's the new one. Don't forget to attach the connectors in the back. Okay, that's connected there. And then put this back here. I gotta turn all the way to the left. So snap it. There you go. That's center. Same thing as this one. I got it all the way to the off position. Snap it. So now we can put everything back. Before we actually put everything back, I would like to test one more time to make sure that connection is good. Let's just start it. It's off. I can hear that turning on. Off. On. That's off. That's good. I hope you can hear it. Fan. There you go. I can hear it clicking too. All right, it's good to go. Then let's put everything back together and we're done. All right, so that's done. And we still get the final test. Okay. As you can see, it's on, off. Make sure everything is working. Radio. Of course, we had a radio code because we removed it. We have the radio code right here in the glove box. As you can see, open that up. 31132. Let's enter it. 31132. That's it. That's it. So what we're gonna do is check everything works. All right, turn it off. Let's go check the Yep, that's off. And then let's see it focus that. Yep, the one is off. So we're done. All right, thank you guys. That's how you diagnose and verify and repair the problem for this AC that won't turn off. Thank you guys. I hope you enjoy it. Just don't forget to put everything back like this one. Okay, we got everything in there. And that's it. Here we go. See you guys next video.